I remember the peaks of Girabania, silent watchmen that would stand long after we were gone. We came seeking allies to join us in the fight against the Empire. People who had had enough. People who had suffered every possible indignity. Who had been treated like animals, day after day after day. Are they Imperials?
Worse. Skulls. Listen, Lys. Whatever happens, stay hidden and do not intervene. Understood?
What?
You there! Halt!
You know you shouldn't be here. Explain yourself.
Forgive me, sir. I came to deliver the tributum.
Oh, aye. A likely story. Only a fool would dare to come so late. Or, mayhap, a resistance spy.
No! No, you've got it all wrong. I was waylaid by bandits. It's not my fault.
I said halt!
Is this a joke? You don't seriously expect us to believe this is a fifth? How stupid do you think we are?
It is, I swear, on my mother's life.
Spare us. You came late, you lied about bandits, and then you tried to cheat the Empire of its due.
Think you can kill them all? Including the ones watching from the tower. Even if you did, others would come for him and his family. You'd be condemning them all to a life of hard labour, assuming they didn't just execute them, that is.
But it isn't fair!
It's your bloody fault we're stuck out here patrolling this God's forsaken wasteland. It's your fault I have to listen to people go on and on about how Alan Egan's can't be trusted. I've worked and toiled harder than any man. I'm a citizen, goddammit. And what are you? A stupid, stubborn little dog who'd sooner bite the hand that feeds him and pine for the good old days.
That's enough! Lord Xenos is expecting our report.
I bet the poor bastard can't believe his luck. He gets to go home. We should do the same.
It is good to see you again, my friends. I hope you are here to tell me you have made contact with the Resistance.
We are, General. Allow me to introduce Monago of Rolga's Reach.
At your service, sir. And may I say what an absolute honor it is to stand before the Bull of Alamigo.
These are not the Blood Sands, girl. You and I are but soldiers on a battlefield fighting for the same cause.
As you say, General. On behalf of Commander Kemp of the Alamegan Resistance, I present to you our formal response.
Good. I'm glad we've reached an accord. Though I was not aware you had suffered such losses.
Aye. Some of our finest took part in the Griffin's doomed assault, and we've been struggling to find new recruits ever since. The massacres cast a pall over the whole Resistance, and many who might once have been open to joining us have since thought better of it.
After all of the Griffin's false promises, one can hardly blame them. They have no desire to give their lives for a lost cause.
We will not lie to them. This is war, and lives will be lost. Yet what we offer is not the fever dream of a madman, but true hope.
The people need proof of this, Father. Let us show it to them. I say we stand shoulder to shoulder with our new allies and engage the Garlians in open warfare. The Resistance must demonstrate that they can hold their own against Imperial Regulars. And with our assistance, I am confident they can do just that. If we can achieve even a token victory, and inspire them to rise up once more.
Aye. Once word spread that we'd won a battle against the Garlians, I'd wager we'd have new recruits flocking to us from Malms around. The question is, when and where do we strike?
I'm glad you asked. I have a plan.
Thank you. Things looked grim for us after Cartano, didn't they? Oh, how they doubted us. Yet here we are, right as rain, with fancy new toys to put through their paces. It's like all my name days have come at once! Well, 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 if it isn't Garland's little troublemaker. I can't wait to see the look on Xenos's face when I bring him your head. That is, if my secret weapons here don't grind it into mush! Attack! Of Magitech design, my arse! I've passed harder stools than these piles of scrap! You'll pay for this! Mark my words, the next time we meet will be the last!
Run and tell your Viceroy! The day belongs to El Amigo! Yeah!
Thank you. Alliance forces have occupied Castrum Oriens and taken up positions along the length of the wall. Our patrols have engaged their reconnaissance parties on site, but there have been no significant exchanges, save one. A unit tasked with field testing prototype Magitech weapons was attacked. The weapons were destroyed, with the unit sustaining near total casualties.
Near total? Go on.
My lord, there was but a single survivor from the unit in question, which falls under my command. According to his report, they were ambushed by a contingent of Eorzean Alliance regulars, abetted by resistance insurgents.
A simple ambush and only one survivor. A fine day's work. The stubbornness to survive is not without worth. He may live. However, the 12th is no place for the weak.
He shall be relegated at once, my lord. As you say, the 12th is no place for cowards who count their lives more precious than the cause.
Indeed, indeed. We have no need of cowards.
My lord,
Cowards, who defer critical missions to their subordinates, who hide within their castra, never meeting their prey in battle, never staring into the whites of their eyes. Why? When confronted with a heretofore unknown icon, did we surrender the wall to the Alliance? Because my honored father, in his infinite wisdom, has not seen fit to grant us leave to march on their lands. Accordingly, we have extended an invitation to our neighbors. Gir Abania is where we shall host them. The field upon which we shall enjoy the sport of kings. Patience is paramount. Cornered animals may have spirit, but they are ultimately predictable and very poor sport. But if one dangles the promise of freedom before them while nipping at their heels to stoke their passion, then things become interesting. It is a delicate dance, one which asks much of my hounds. And so I put the question to you, my fellow huntsmen. How shall we deal with these savages?
My lord, I have a proposal.
Silence, Alamegan! You do forget yourself! Only by the grace of Lord Van Baelsar were you afforded a place here, and that in name alone. We have no need of your proposals, savage.
This savage yearns to hunt her own. The floor is yours, Commander.
Thank you, my lord.